My name is Musa Mhlanga. I'm a scientist. I work on immuno-oncology, but fundamentally I work on how genes are regulated, and it's with a focus on RNA and chromatin architecture. Well, I've been involved with the single cell community for several years, and also with the Human Cell Atlas. And I guess the reason that we came to this meeting, myself and a postdoc from my lab, is we had some interesting new data we wanted to present. I think one of the themes that really stood out for me was a lot of the work that's going on in cancer, but specifically in cancer resistance, and how single cell technology can really illuminate that not only for scientists, but also for clinicians. Single cell biology is really a data science, a big data science, uniquely. So we're seeing, I think, the power of the data science tools being applied to what is an increasing amount of single cell data that's emerging from many different directions and many different tissues, many different models, many different diseases. So I think technologically, one of the key things that's emerged at this meeting is the integration of imaging data, or spatial transcriptomics, is really starting to emerge into a lot of the talks that we're seeing. And then I think another thing that's also coming through quite strongly at this meeting, at least, is the computational tools are becoming much more adept at fishing out really like specific phenotypes and genes that we, you know, would be obscured in, you know, they have to be carefully sifted through. But because we have these very powerful computational tools, we can actually drill down to very, 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 you know, hidden genes, so to speak, to identify key phenotypes. So that's really, I think for me, that's one of the strong emerging themes. But also, you know, there's another thing that comes with the ability to use those kind of tools, is that we can do very high throughput experiments. And because before, high throughput experiments meant a lot of data to analyze. Now, you know, we don't shy away from doing, you know, huge, massive high throughput experiments. And I think what we're seeing also is that the future is going to involve perhaps, you know, not the tens or hundreds of thousands of cells that we're used to working with, but literally millions of individual cells. So the data is also scaling quite rapidly. But the computational tools seem to be keeping up. I think being back in person has been wonderful. You know, serendipity of meeting in person is the big thing from meetings. I've gotten so used to watching meetings on Zoom that I have to admit that for a few talks at this meeting, I kind of prefer to watch them in my room on the video feed. Just because I felt more comfortable doing that for many reasons. But it's nice to be back in person. It's nice to interact with people. It's nice to form collaborative relationships. Also, it's nice to be able to ask people more questions about their work than we'd ordinarily do. So yeah, I think it would be very difficult actually to recreate that serendipity that we have and that those types of interactions remotely. So I'm really excited that we're back in person. Many people would love to interact with speakers after they give a talk or beforehand. And it's difficult to form collaborative networks and collaborative relationships with people that you kind of never really get to talk to in person. So if we look at it from the way science works today, we really need these collaborative interactions to be strengthened. We need these effects, these network effects, which occur much more efficiently in person, to really foster and synergize collaborations. And in-person meetings do that. Well, I think the single cell community is a really labile phase. We have a lot of people who are adopting single cell technology, And a lot of them are coming to this meeting from very diverse fields of biology, plants, bacteria, cancer, developmental biology, unique model organisms that are being used, from fly to C. elegans and others. And I think that means that scientists with very diverse backgrounds are meeting at these conferences. I think what's going to happen, though, is the technology is going to become subservient to the biology. That's going to refragment the field, essentially. And what's going to happen is single cell technology is going to be subservient to whatever biological questions people have in their siloed domains. So the plant people will go back to having plant meetings where people will be presenting single cell technology, but just in plants. So I guess the great thing about this sort of meeting is that you can be exposed to diverse types of biology using a shared technology. And I think for me, that's really inspiring. I think the best science happens when you can bring multiple fields together. So now is really the time to attend this sort of meeting.